Hey, how's it going? A few days back, I came across that same old discussion that I had with another entrepreneurial friend of mine about how much equity you should give up when you're raising funds. So I thought I'd put together this piece to rest that argument once and for all. Let me start off with a couple of examples first. The first example is Warren Buffett, the world's third richest man with a net worth of $85 billion. He owns less than 30% of Berkshire Hathaway, his company. If you don't know what Berkshire Hathaway is, it's a company that owns other companies like Coca-Cola, Apple. The second example is Bill Gates. If you're concerned about the fact that Bill Gates is no longer the richest man, well, he's been the richest man for the last 15 of 20 years. With a net worth of $94 billion, he owns less than 5% of Microsoft. Actually, some people put it at 1% today. The third example is Jeff Bezos. I consider taking off Jeff Bezos this list because of all the recent things with Lauren Sanchez. Let me know in the comments down below if you think that a man's personal life impacts his other achievements. Jeff Bezos has a net worth of $137 billion. He owns less than 14% of Amazon.com. So there are basically three reasons why an entrepreneur should not be afraid to give up equity in his company. The first is, this is the world we live in, a world of inorganic growth where a startup founder goes to an investor, convinces him with the passion of his idea, and gives up equity in his company. The second reason is the fact that 1% of $1 billion is worth a whole lot more than 100% of $1 million. The third reason is that it is your company. It cannot exist without you. You know that old saying that goes that if you love something, you should let it go. If it doesn't come back to you, it was never yours. But if it does, it's yours forever. That's similar to an entrepreneur and his company. One of the main reasons that an entrepreneur is afraid is because he or she is afraid of giving up control. But if you think about it, how much control do we have over anything in life, really? Can you imagine Amazon.com without Jeff Bezos? There is an almost holy link between the company and the founder. It cannot and does not exist without him or her. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends who are entrepreneurs, comment down below with your questions, and go over to YouTube and subscribe to Vlog of Note. I will see you guys on Monday.